The seat of the Absolute, and the source of our altered tadpoles. Stay your blade when you're able. Interrogate who you can. Answers first, bloodshed later.
So this is the abode of our dear Absolute. It's about as cheerful as expected.
Cazador, Sired Sevenspawn, me and my six brothers and sisters. He always insisted we were a family, even when he was carving scars into our flesh. I was one of his first. Some of the others came years later. He was a monster to us all, but did take special pleasure in my pain. He said, my screams sounded sweetest. And now that I'm gone, I don't know. I pity the other six.
This is the seat of the Absolute's power. Whatever the heart is, it's connected to this place somehow. We must find out.
Doesn't stink like an overstuffed cemetery, which means Balthazar hasn't returned. So why are you here instead of out there looking for him?
Once again, your mind opens to Lazelle, and she considers the disc.
More writings on Orpheus, the so-called Prince of the Comet. The Prince of the Comet, Part 3. The histories tell us that Commander Voss, Justil Kithrak, pierced Prince Orpheus clean through with his Sword of Silver. That his flesh was torn and fed to the great red dragon Ephelamon. Vlakith's faithful roar out this tale, but beneath the roars, we hear whispers carrying truth and prophecy. The Prince of the Comet is not dead. The Prince of the Comet will come again. The Prince of the Comet will liberate us from Vlakith's tyranny. Praise be to Mother Gith, Queen of the One Sky. Praise be to your son, Orpheus, the true heir, Prince of the Comet. This is more than a fable. It's an affront to the undying Queen Vlakith. Gith's son died to Voss's blade. Orpheus is no more. Tiamat's emissary. It was he who carried word that Mother Gith had negotiated the gift of the dragons, and that Vlakith the First would preside as queen of the Githyanki. Ithalamon remains the queen's consort to this day, as endless as the empire he now serves. It is not just improbable, it is impossible. Kithrak Vos and his red dragon slayed the fell prince. You could no more resurrect him than you could glue together the pile of ashes he became. My Vash taught that the silver bells of Vlakith's court still ring out before every hunt in celebration of the prince's defeat. As a child, I longed to hear them for myself and sing in praises to the deathless queen and her Githraki. Anything more?
Seek and you shall find me.
The corpse remains silent.
Let's move. What's that? Should mind my step.
I spy with my little eye. Nothing of note, really. Thank you.
hardly feel this spinning.
Praying for mercy from other gods, won't I? Adored Minthar, brought up from the darkness and into the Absolute's light.
She cherished you, but it wasn't enough. You were distracted by your own desires.
Bloodlust, murder, chaos.
And most damning of all, an unexpected weakness. A longing for acceptance and affection from a mortal.
You have no right!
We have every right. You are nothing.
Minthara's mind connects with yours. Not strong as you remember it, but fractured, disintegrating.
Come to observe, true soul. She is a lesson. None can rise so high that they cannot fall again. We are erasing her. Willful, though. But you are right. Whatever is useful, we will leave intact.
None of you will break me!
Wrong!
What is this? Pity? Rebellion? Blasphemy? Stand down, or we will put you down! I don't know who you are, true soul, but under General Thorne's command, everybody has their duties. Learn yours, and stick to them.
And we will stick to ours. Goodbye, Minthara. Hello, Minthara. How do you feel?
Ecstatic. Devoted. Inspired.
Excellent. A job well done, sister.
For the Absolute.
For the Absolute. I serve the Absolute.
Minthara has broken. Find another to break, and let me be witness.
Queen of Spider.
You were adored, Minthara.
She checked
Bloodla.
And most damning.
You have no.
We have F. You are.
Minthara's mind.
Come to observe, true soul. She is a lesson. None can rise so high. We are erasing her. Is our duty.
Peace, sister. Let us observe the true soul's methods. Perhaps we can learn from them. Her mind is yours. Break it.
Immediately, your mind is swept into a greater vortex. A psionic storm with Minthara at its center.
Cannot hide. Submit. Embrace.
Her torturers are not dominating her. They are destroying her mental defenses and exposing her to something else. The Absolute. Navigating the storm, you reach the nexus of her mind. It is a wound, bleeding raw emotion and shattered memories. But she senses your arrival.
You came.
I prayed that you would. But there are no gods left to me. This thing that speaks inside me, it has all but destroyed me. But it fears you. Even so, I cannot resist it while my tormentors live. I didn't dare hope. I owe you more than my life. I would prefer to make these bastards bleed. But I trust that you speak from caution rather than cowardice. I will put my faith in you and pretend to be their slave.
Her mind fills with warmth, and she gently releases you.
Is it done? I did not feel her mind break. Look a little vacant, sister. No more anger. No more doubt. She is perfect. We ought to return to our posts, sister. There'll be plenty more prisoners to practice on. An ill thing to let an enemy show their back and live. And look at you, right here with me. I suggest we leave, silently.
Our enemies are everywhere.
Never a dull moment. What path lies before me? Wish I had a bag of holding.
At your command. I belong in darkness.
Time to press ahead. What do we have here?
It is impossible to keep a garment clean down here.
You'll find it all the harder once we're off on the march.
If you think I'm walking all the way to Baldur's Gate without a litter, you don't know me at all.
Everyone back this. Nice and quiet now. On my way.
so soon. Follow Doss.
With every breath, a purpose.
Surprised you spotted me.
The shadows.
With every breath, a purpose.
Adventuring.
Thara is supposed to be in a cell. You have some explaining to do.
You really do have a way with words. You need my expertise.
Thank you.
quite ready for you.
What to do?
Lovely day this, for now.
Think ahead, or I'm lost. Never wanted the easy path.
I applaud your taste. One with the weave.
I can be subtle sometimes. Should have worn better boots.
Ready and willing.
Let's not get caught off guard.
The air is ripe with magic. Work my magic.
Do we have a target?
Yes.
I hope this is important, for your sake.
salutations.
I can't waste any more time.
Quiet. Keeping low.
Which way to the nearest line?
Reporting.
Kyone.
Charmed, I'm sure. Robes will get dirty.
Just hurry this along.
Shadows.
Quietly.
An excellent choice. Most excellent.
My patience wanes.
Darkness is my home.
Don't mind me.
Do not distract me.
Still in shadow. Unheard, unseen.
Keep your eye close. The element of surprise.
Shouldn't have wished to live in more interesting times. Something's on my mind.
No rest for the wicked, I see. By all means. Very well.
What to do? What's up for discussion? Don't waste a step.
What? I see a path.
Every breath, a purpose, light, steps. Out of sight. Repositioning.
Enjoy the view. This feels like it stretch all the way to the Sea of Swords in a clear day. If this place ever gets a clear day.
So might as well.
Still breathing, despite everything.
You can see me?
Looking ahead. Very well. Wonder if the gods are watching me.
Action, not reaction. One true way.
One step at a time.
From Waterdeep. Onward.
No one back home will ever believe this. Is that blood? No, never mind. have a lot on my mind and, well, in it.
Blackets will be done. Repositioning.
Subtle stacks.
Lost in thought.
Adventure awaits.
Direct me.
Hush.
Let's get going. Something to ask. At the ready.
Shall I silence? Enough waiting. I crave blood.
What now?
Oh, I have the magic touch. With silver tongue.
Not now.
Well, hello. Tread carefully.
Onward. I will be heard.
Watch your back.
Can't give up now.
Yes. Whisper your command. Quickly, then.
Delicious.
Have it ready.
That way.
No one stopped me yet.
None shall see me.
Blood. We must speak. Huh?
You have my attention.
Keep your distance, darling.
Oh, I have the magic touch.
Someone there.
All right. What now? Have to keep going. Still alive,
so that's progress.
Another step forward.
Quietly.
Moving.
Seek and you shall find me.
Lights will be done.
Road ahead. With haste.
Need a throat slitting.
I last left Moonrise as a commander in the Absolute's army, obeying the voice of a god. I thought I had found a home and a purpose.
Now I leave as an exile. But you risked your life to rescue me. For that, I am grateful.
The artifact connects with her, pulling your minds together and showing her all that you have seen. The prism, your dream visitor, the protection that keeps you from obeying the Absolute and becoming a Lithid. She knows it all in a moment. Her mind reels, but is no longer clouded. She accepts the truth. She has no choice.
There is much we must discuss. Do you have a safe place to camp nearby? Goodbye for now. I will see you soon.
All's well that ends. Yeah, not as bad as it could have.
What's on your mind?
One day I'll catch a break. What's inside? That sign above. This must be a brewery or distillery.
I'm sure a place like
Welcome
this
to
has
the waning moon. To lifelong friends, both old and new.
Payday gold in my pouch is clinking, say hey for the pub. A single fort is what I'm thinking, say hey for the pub. See your winking, say hey for the pub.
Halflings and gnomes order here.
Thank you.
It does not compare with the comforts of home, but your camp is almost palatial in comparison to my previous accommodation. Thank you for allowing me to come here and for bringing me back to myself. Each memory that returns to me is more disturbing than the last. The things that I did in the name of the Absolute. The things that were done to me. They broke my mind. The best cure is vengeance. For both of us. While our tadpoles live, and the cult have the means to control them, we will never be safe. We must eradicate them. Starting with General Thorm. I mean Ketherick. My deference to him is a habit that will die hard, I fear. It is the safest place to be. Swear that you will keep me close. Until the Absolute is dead, at least. Prism will protect me. You will fight alongside me and help me to get my vengeance. I knew you were different to other true souls when we met, but I could see nothing clearly. Now, thanks to the Prism, the Absolute does not cloud my thoughts at all. I see that together, we can have our vengeance on those who infected us. Rest well, and keep your wits about you. Tomorrow, we go to war with the cult of the Absolute. I intend to cause plenty, but only for our enemies.
This dark land must be filled with the broken, the beaten, the desperate. The perfect praying ground for a devil who offers a way out for those who sign on the dotted line. I hope we end up seeing our friend Raphael down here somewhere. You don't have to sign anything. Just help me find him. When I was taken to his house, I was caught off guard. But now I know what to ask for. I'm sure he'll turn up at one point or another.
Minthar is something of a closed book, but I suspect a heart of gold lurks beneath that stern countenance. Once she gets to know me, I'm sure she'll open up. She's just waiting for someone ready to listen.
Thank you.
I need a moment for the two of us.
The drow is unpredictable, uncompromising. I respect her almost as much as I distrust her.
Things have stayed interesting.
I want to be clear. Letting Minthara tag along with us was your idea. So if you wake up with a dagger to your throat, that's on you. Oh, excuse me. I'm sorry for looking out for our collective hides. But fine. Take her if you wish. Just know I'll be resting with one eye open.
Oh, darling, I'm hurt. I thought we had something special. I guess I'll spend my evenings lounging here while you do all the hard work. It sounds awful.
If not over, then through. I should speak up.
Good. I do not like to stand idle. You wish to consult me? I took up my oath long ago, when I swore bloody vengeance against any who defied Loth. Now, I myself have sinned against the Spider Queen. Though my faith is shattered, my oath endures. I am sworn to destroy all those who serve the Absolute. Do you think me a fool? If it were blood I wanted, I would choose easier victims rather than challenging gods and cosmic aberrations. Abandon your preconceptions of who I am and why I act, and know this. My fight against the cult is righteous. We are all that stands between this world and annihilation. I was the Absolute's dagger. I remember every throat that it held me to, and every drop of blood it forced me to spill. I take no responsibility for the lives I took. I did nothing in the Absolute's name. I was merely a weapon that it wielded.
I'd rather die than endure it again. The tadpole. The absolute. They work together like a drug. I did not feel I was compelled to act against my will. I felt ecstatic to serve. Every action seemed a deliberate choice. The best choice. Even though I could no more have resisted its commands than flesh can resist decay. Even rational minds like ours cannot reject such a powerful influence. The Absolute can make the impossible seem inevitable. A disparate collection of vagabonds and strays. Did you have anyone particular in mind? The wizard? No. It is pointless. In my experience, the moment they leave their libraries, wizards have the life expectancy of a gnome in a war. Either the enemy recognizes they are a threat and kills them swiftly, or their curiosity leads them to combust while experimenting with the limits of magic. Our wizard is already in a state of suspended combustion, thanks to that orb between his ribs. I suspect it is only a matter of time before he goes up in smoke. I will reserve my social graces for those who might live long enough to appreciate them. I have encountered few Githyanki in my life. Those that I did were raiders. They croaked out pleas for mercy in their alien tongue as they died. Meeting Lazelle makes me wish I knew more of their culture. To one who only sees the surface of things, perhaps, you should look deeper. In spite of her youth, there is a patience and precision in Lazelle's thoughts and actions that I admire. Those qualities will strengthen as she matures. He's been deprived of freedom and strong blood for so long that he is addicted to both. While those addictions have their hold on him, he is still a slave. Free. What purpose does he have that does not involve his master? He fears him, he hates him, he dreams of him, and he will either kill him or die trying. Astarion is no more free of Cazador than you or I are free of our tadpoles. He will only be free when Cazador is dead. And that is as it should be. When the time comes, we must hope that he does not only take Cazador's long life, but the power that has sustained him as well.
Our enemies still draw breath.
Thank you.
violence breeds madness.
Your name. Next.
No time to rest. These boots have seen everything. Here we go.
Awaiting orders. Agreed.
alive, so that's progress.
So, you found the seat of the Absolute's power. And what a power it is. I trust you've come to your senses. We have to work together, or the Absolute will enthrall us both. I cannot keep this up indefinitely. Catherick Thorm is clearly important, but I wonder if there's more to it than that. It just doesn't stop. We are being bombarded by waves of telepathic energy. Wave after wave with hardly a breath between them. I almost dare not rest. Each wave a set of orders to the infected. The order for your transformation has been given many times already. I just hope my powers last long enough to see this through. In any case, the Absolute knows you carry me with you now. It wants to retrieve me. I stole it from Blackith. Her continued rule depends on it. As long as the Absolute exists, I am trapped within the prison. I can only control the power from here. We must make sure Blackith never gets her hands on the prison. Nor the Absolute. Unfortunately, they are both dedicating more and more resources to retrieving it. The task ahead is monumental. But we're all that stands between victory for the Absolute and freedom for all. This is not just about you and I anymore. It has become far bigger than us. You must infiltrate Moonrise Towers, discover the secrets of the Absolute, and put an end to it. So we can finally be free. Now I must rest. And you must carry on. Do not let my efforts be in vain.
For me.
We must press forward. Let's deal with Kethrick, then find Voss in Baldur's Gate.
Always at your side.
What's on your mind?
Losing energy, losing focus.
Thank you.
I don't know you. Perhaps I forgot you.
Right.
It used to be music.
Corrupted him beyond comprehension.
Leaning in, you can see how the creature's skin barely holds it together. The bulge of its belly is on the cusp of bursting wide open.
Near to bursting. The next few sips could be his last.
Go on, please. Make it drink! Be drunk! You and I both! To our good health!
Burns your throat as you swallow, but otherwise you feel no ill effects.
Again! Father Ketherick created, Father Ketherick sustains. Drink it in, toss it down, lap it up.
Rumbles as the vile brew fills it, yet your mind remains miraculously steady. Creature's brew is more potent than anything you ever drank before. You feel instantly drunk and unsteady on your feet.
I know you. I am knowing. mysterious secret. Secret? No. Not never. Father sent. Ordered. Commanded. Don't say it. Don't say it. Urcage. Urcage. Talk and perish. Die. Buried. Buried in Thorn Tomb. Father told me. I can't perish. No. Nay. Neither. Too strong. Too.
Do mess our pardon. Our master distiller spills quite the caused. Now settle your mind, chum, and get your shine on. Be will it what? Moon, mountain dark, coming right up. A man of proper taste. To chum yourself up and whisk the old luggage at Jugbug you. So be what?
The curse has left him with as much sense as a newborn slug.
Right away, sir. Yes, sir.
On my way.
Looks real. Superb. Encore. I should hit the road. I'm so tired.
Sorry. Terrible. I'll clean up right mess that.
Never mind.
battle.
At least things have stayed interesting. Light on my feet.
Research notes. They describe a powerful venom extracted from a rare purple worm. Distiller Thisible Thorm sought to create a fatal poison using the worm's gullet. He procured several parts of a worm gullet, but rinsed one in error. The poison he brewed was noxious, but not fatal. Thisible devoted months to formulating a deadly poison with the remaining ingredients, without success. After exhaustive experimentation, he was able to make a near-deadly extract from the glands. But to complete his poison, Thisibald required one last ingredient, the petals of a corpse rose. The book's index reveals corpse roses may grow near tombs, mausoleums, and particularly redolent cadavers. Thisibald enlisted a courier from Baldur's Gate to obtain corpse rose petals and other ingredients and deliver them to a covert location. Unfortunately, a deep purple stain darkens the final page, obscuring the parcel's destination. Your mind separates the black from the blue, revealing the stash's location. You mark your map as a reminder. With the corpse rose petals the package contains, you might create Thisibald's purple worm poison.
Better be careful not to trigger that thing.
Bet I can crack that open.
If it is for the best.
Looking ahead.
Eager for battle.
Ah, excellent choice.
I've got a long road ahead. Slow down.
You wish to consult me?
Here goes nothing.
Renovations! Please, clutter the garden.
Waning Moon Distillery. No last call until the casks are dry.
Thank you.
missing? Rascal, brown puppy, Jagoda, black and white cat, Zola. That's a lot of missing pets.
Here, House of Healing. West, Baldur's Gate. East, Central Square.
House of Healing, from the looks of it.
Here to see the doctor? Are we poorly? Are we desperately poorly? Or not so well, but well enough to wait. Join the line, and you will be seen.
Victims await.
Thank you. swords meet sorcery with ease. These mortals be.
Ready for battle. Worth my time.
one can't always be a gentleman.
His head away in shame. His neighbors would not renounce Saluna. Now they hang in the town square. You feel a rush of outrage. This woman worshipped Shah to the end, so why does the Night Singer's curse not spare her? You see a man drain his tankard in an inn as he listens to a flaming fist play the lute. He's better than his uniform might suggest.
Give up now. That might be worth a look. Seems simple enough. What was that? The curse has no effect here. What is this place?